Hello everybody, welcome back on my channel. I know that today I'm speaking English, usually we don't speak English here, but today we have a special guest, so I'm wanting to introduce to you Leo Posin, the CEO of AutoDS and also business owner with more than 20 eBay store on dropshipping. Hello Leo, thank you for being here today. Nice to meet you. Can you introduce to my channel? Who are you? What do you do?
Well, so hello everybody. My name is Leo. Daniel, thanks for having me here today in this channel. I'm super excited about this interview, and I'm super excited to give this value and this interview for your audience, so we can actually really give good value for the Italy audience on your YouTube channel and for everyone who is watching that. So, so as I said, my name is Leo. I started with dropshipping around 11 years ago when I was basically a kid, 14 years old. How I started is that I searched to buy a phone online, and I saw that the price on eBay was much higher than the price on the site that I saw before, which was a Chinese site. So I just tried to dropship this product without any tool, without anything, just manually copy everything. And within like 3 or 4 hours, I sold this. So like 6 years, I started the AutoDS, which the main purpose of that was to automate all my stores, mine and my partner stores, and run an automatic dropshipping business and just creating more and more e-commerce stores. But as time passed, we heard, yeah?
How long have been when you started? How many years ago?
So it was like almost 5 years ago. 4.5 years ago from now.
So you started dropshipping 5 years ago, right?
No, dropshipping I started 11 years ago, and AutoDS I started like 5 years ago.
Nice. So AutoDS just has been launched 5 years ago. And how did you handle on this time your dropshipping business when still AutoDS was not here?
You mean how I handled it?
Yeah.
So at this time, everything was manually using some VAs. So we hired VAs, which is virtual assistant, people who could help us remotely to manage the stores. They were helping us with the customer support. And basically the main point was their orders fulfillment. So they processed all of the orders for us manually, one by one. And then because I am a developer, so I just started to automate part of the things. Firstly, it was funny and a bit did damage to me. Like we had a lot of problems and a lot of duplicate orders during the process while we developed it. But as the time went, we started to remove more tasks from manual and move it to automation using the software that we created for ourselves at this time, and today it's AutoDS.
So basically you start the software AutoDS for yourself, and you saw that was really good for your business, and you decided to share with everybody this.
Yeah, exactly. So we went to some conferences, showed it to some people. Hey, look what we are doing for ourselves. And people told us, why you don't like opening it for everyone to use. And yeah, that's how it started. So that's how we published it and then opened it first for big users and then for smaller users and then for everyone.
Yeah, that's nice. I suppose this helped you with your business as well. So how many stores you have today on eBay after 11 years?
Yeah, so right now we have like around 35 stores that we run by ourselves. And we also have the e-commerce project that we run on some other platforms. So that's what we do.
Yeah, it's a very huge number, 35. and how many products you have around these stores?
Mostly each eBay store has around 10,000 listings. So 35 stores, it's around 350,000 listings on eBay.
So, you know, on Italy, I see that a lot of people is asking to me, how can I find good products to sell and what products should I sell? So when they have like 500,000 listings, they could be confused. They could think, oh, how can it's possible to find all these products? So maybe you can explain to them, why are you going for too many products? Why you have so huge catalog on eBay?
Yeah, so let's start first with why, and then we can talk about how we do that. So the reason why we do that is because I'm a huge believer of the big numbers rule on eBay. And the big numbers rule means that I will list everything that looks hot for me. It can be movers and shakers. It can be anything that is trendy or some other methods that I will mention soon today in the interview. But the thing is that on eBay, it's a game of keywords. It means that if someone is looking to find something and you have more different products, it will give more chances for them to find your product. Because if I have 10,000 products, each product has 80 keywords in the 80 characters in the title, it means that I can go for much, much more products than if I would have just 100 products. And also, in my opinion, it's much less time consuming. It's much easier to go this way. It's much easier to just upload a lot of products than go and research each product manually and optimize everything manually there. Both of methods can work, but I'm a huge believer of the big numbers rule. More than that, what I do is that when something proves itself, when I see that something actually works, I will go and optimize this specific product. So for this product that already showed me that it worth my attention and my time or the time of the of our team, so only these products will get optimized. And also we will list more products of this type. So if I sold a mouse, for example, I will go to the supplier of this mouse and list more mouses of this type because I see that this mouse or this type of products is working well for me.
Yeah, so specifically, you go for the hot categories you find using your products as tests. So basically, you use your own products as tests for finding the good niche and you use them. Is this the process you do with eBay? And yes, I think that many people is confusing because they are coming from Shopify dropshipping that is totally different than, you know, dropshipping on marketplace like eBay or Facebook. It's no sense when you have so much traffic for free, focus on one product, two products, just go in and become very, very, very big so people can find you easy. The point is this. And can maybe you share with me what has been very hard on your dropshipping travel, on your dropshipping business on these years? Maybe the other things you found?
What, that were hard for me?
Yeah, something that you were very, very, very happy to fix on this year. For yourself or maybe for your company?
Yeah, so one thing that took for me time to understand is the support on eBay. So it's easy to get sales in the beginning, but then if you don't give good support to your customers, you will be just suspended or your traffic will go lower. And what we found is that like giving the highest priority for the customer support and customer experience on our stores is super important. And maybe it's even the most important part of this entire business. So when we optimized this, we started to see much less suspended stores, much less problems, much less negative feedbacks. And everything became much, much better because eBay Maybe you can see in some places that they say that they are against dropshipping or something like that, but actually what eBay is trying to do is to have good sellers. If someone is giving a good customer experience and a good customer support to their customers, so for 100% eBay will like them because they are giving good experience to the visitors of eBay site. And that's why we put highest priority on the customer support and basically on customer experience. It's not only the support, meaning if an order comes, we will try to send this order as soon as possible. We will not wait the order at all. We will do that as fast as possible. And if we can use automation for that, we will use automation for that. But the order needs to be shipped as soon as possible and the client needs to get answers as soon as possible.
Yeah, this is what I say. Maybe on any video I publish on this channel, just go for the best customer possible. Even if you lose money sometime in short term, doesn't matter, because on long term, for sure you will have more money because your store will be just live, will be with more traffic. And so we are going for this question. Do you think that is allowed to shipping on eBay today on 2021?
So what eBay's policy says is that it's not allowed from marketplaces, for example, like Amazon, Walmart, and so on. But there are still few options. The first option is wholesale suppliers or private suppliers. You can find them in many different sites. For example, you can work with AliExpress and then it's not a problem. Or for example, now we are adding some Italy suppliers also to AutoDS like Banggood. Europe that can work for you and then you can get contracts from them. But even if you work with Amazon, as I said, if you give a good customer experience, eBay will not touch your account and will not do anything. All what eBay is trying to do with this new policy, which is already like 2 years old, is to get good sellers and to cover themselves. eBay want the ability to tell you, hey, you're a dropshipper, so we suspended your account, because many dropshippers are coming to make easy money and they're not looking on their business like a real business. But if you take in mind that the business is actually a business, it's a dropshipping business, it has the word business, and it means that you need actually to put attention to that, to put attention to your brand, to your store, and give good experience. And then maybe it's against eBay's policy, but eBay will not do anything to your store because they will like you and you will give a value to them and to their customers.
Yes, many people are saying just don't use eBay because eBay could suspend you, eBay could disallow drop shipping, just don't go for hover. But this is not very true, because I know for sure that because I drop shipping for myself on eBay for many years, you drop shipping, and I know that AutoDS got a lot of people drop shipping on eBay using Amazon, for example, that I know that is your favorite supplier for drop shipping on eBay, actually is mine as well, because maybe you can say why Amazon is so good supplier for drop shipping today.
Yeah, so first, that's true, like 95% of the dropshippers are using Amazon, and people maybe will hear that and say, okay, I want to be different and I want to go to a place where no competition. That's not true, because first, Amazon has enough products for everyone, and doesn't matter if you go to other suppliers, still Amazon will have these niches and mostly also the products. Amazon is a good supplier because of fast shipping. That's the first thing. It's very reliable. You can know exactly that what you're looking for, that's exactly the product that you will get. Otherwise, the seller on Amazon will be suspended. So if they have already feedbacks, meaning they are good sellers. And third, Amazon has their own customer support, which is perfect. It's very easy to get return labels. It's very easy to communicate about orders and check what's going on with the statuses. Their shipping is very fast, and then their best supplier, it's super easy. It's much easier than starting working with private suppliers or or breaking your head with all this headache with working with Chinese suppliers. It's much harder and it's much easier to go for a local supplier, big one with a name, with they know what they do, they know what they want you to get from them. This is their most, like they put most of the focus on customer experience, which is exactly what eBay wants. So I think that Amazon is a perfect supplier.
Yes, and today a lot of companies that don't ship, but they like stock their goods on Amazon warehouse, so people just is comfort to see Amazon box on their home, because sometimes they just order on website and people use just Amazon FBA for send items to home. So it's perfectly normal, because a lot of people is just thinking, okay, Amazon box, people see Amazon logo, but this is no problem at all, because Amazon today is not just a supplier, but is a logistic company as well. So people is using for it for any order, for any kind of business. So this is perfectly normal. And so you say that Amazon got a lot of products. So how can you find good products to drop shipping from Amazon when you have over 400 million products on stock?
Yeah. So we have a few options for that. The first option is just to go for movers and shakers on Amazon, which is the thing that Amazon are saying that, hey, this is trendy right now. And this product went from place number 1,000 to place number 15. And then you can know that this product is something that people are looking for and it's rising right now. The second option is using the products that you already sold. If you already sold something, as I said before, you can go and maximize it using similar products to that one. The third option, and we use that for many stores, is the Autodesk Finder. The Autodesk Finder is a tool that scans over 40,000 dropshippers on eBay and in general in the network, and getting their top sellers, put it on our database, finding similar products to that also, and then you can get access to all these products with a click of a button. So basically you can go to Autodesk, go to the Finder, say, hey, I want to get 100 products that sold at least 8 times in the last month, and that's exactly what you will get. So these are the three main options. You can also use some product finding methods or tools that exist out there. You can look for them and use them, but these are the cheapest, and the most of them are also free methods. So yeah.
So basically, AutoDS can find products for you and you can sell them, and AutoDS can also order them for you and send to customers. So basically, AutoDS can cover almost all the work behind this business on eBay.
Yeah, so Amazon AutoDS covers the products finding, uploading them with the click of a button, with some minimal optimization that you can also do automatically. It can raise and decrease your prices according to the competition. It means that if your product doesn't sell, it will decrease the price. And if it sells, it will increase the price automatically for you. And then it will process the orders for you and update the tracking numbers automatically when it's available on the supplier's site. One important thing here is that, as I said, the customer experience and customer support are the most important parts of this business. And this way, soon we will also release a customer support system where you will have also ready-made templates that you can use for any case that your customers are asking about. You will be able to manage their all your stores together, customer cases, returns, cancellations and messages, and everything will be there in this system. So that's the last part that we didn't cover still, and it will be available very soon on the new AutoDS.
Oh, this is awesome. So basically AutoDS can cover all the work and you can just enjoy your time. I think this was your goal with with the company, give the possibility to people to have financial freedom so they can care, so they can care about other things or focus on the business and automate all these tasks that are coming from, you know, from day by day on the business. And because many people told me that maybe eBay has a lot of competitors or different than Shopify, because on Shopify you can scale much bigger, but of course you need much money. And of course you need a lot work than eBay, because on eBay you can automate all the work. So you can, what I explain to people that on eBay you can scale with two ways. You can scale with one store, but you can scale with many stores as well. And you can do this just if you have a good software that automates all the process. Because when you have like 20 or 30 stores, it's impossible to go every day on each store and do every task, because you will need 30 people. So it's important to have one core, one software that manage all these tasks for you. And it's very good. And so I'm very curious to know how many dropshippers are today on AutoDS.
So on AutoDS right now, we have 10,000 dropshippers. Lately, we also opened the AutoDS for Shopify dropshipping. And this is also something that we are rising there right now. So most of them are on eBay, but now we are also started on the Shopify market to have more people there, to help more people there to automate their businesses also, and not only on eBay. And soon also we will add Amazon, Wix, WooCommerce, and some other marketplaces.
Okay, now to just help people on Shopify. So what are the pros to use AutoDS for Shopify?
So for Shopify, we do everything really similar to what we do with eBay. So every process there also automated. For products finding on Shopify, it's a bit different, and you need to do that on other methods than what we discussed about today and until now. Because the method how we work on Shopify is different. It's not a big numbers rule there, because you need to bring the traffic. But except that, for products uploading and automated orders or tracking updates, everything is done also automatically.
Oh, this is good. So people can automate all the process for example, ordering from Amazon or AliExpress also, because I know that AutoDS has like managed fulfilled by AutoDS, that basically when people get orders from Shopify, AutoDS will send us orders from AliExpress using your accounts. So people doesn't need to care about ordering from AliExpress or having accounts locked, or all this is coming when you use suppliers like AliExpress.
Yeah.
And maybe I think people is curious to know who is the bigger dropshipper that you have on AutoDS.
So I cannot really say names, but we have some dropshippers with a million of products. People are making, like, this is what they do. Tens of thousands of dollars in profit a month. One of the biggest also is Daniel. We have many big customers, and most of them are, not most of them, but everybody who I see with big amounts of profits are going for the big numbers rule that we discussed about today. One tip there is, even when you go for the big numbers rule, still try to optimize the things that are working for you, so it will bring you more profits. But yeah, about your question, so it's around 1 up to 2 million of products for these customers.
Are they for eBay dropshipping, right? Or do you have some big dropshipper on Shopify too?
On Shopify, the dropshippers are not counting by amount of products, but by amount of sales. And yeah, we have the dropshippers who are making thousands of sales a day. I saw one of 3,000, 4,000 orders a day on Shopify store.
Yeah, this is amazing. And where do you see AutoDS as company? Let's talk a little bit about your company on the future. What is the goal of AutoDS on long term, on the next year or next years?
Yeah, so first, AutoDS came to be a time saver. So it has two things. The first one is time saving, and the second one is all-in-one platform. So in terms of all-in-one platform, we are looking for to extend for more suppliers in any marketplace, and also for more selling channels like Amazon, Wix, WooCommerce, Walmart, and so on. Lately, we also released the dropshipping to Facebook Marketplace, for example, which is one of them. And in terms of time saving, we want to have more smart features for product finding, for automations, for customer support, more things that will really automate the business and really save more time. Yeah, so that's our main goal right now, more suppliers, more selling channels, and more automations. We are really looking for questions about features. That's why we have the feedback.autodesk.com, where people can actually go and request features so we can really listen to them and develop the things that will help these people to automate their businesses. Yeah, so that's for the near future.
Yeah, this is why I love AutoDS, because it's done by dropshipper for dropshipper, because I know that a lot people inside AutoDS are dropshippers, and they started as dropshipper after jump to work with AutoDS. And so AutoDS can know really well what people need for their business, and is very, very good. And also you spoke now about Facebook dropshipping. It's something that I spoke on my channel, and people is very, very, very interested, and they are asking for more info about it. So maybe you can share something about Facebook with us today.
So you had some lags. So if I understood you right, you want to hear more about Facebook Marketplace dropshipping?
Yes, it's something that here is very, very interesting. So maybe you can share something.
Yeah, so the Facebook Marketplace dropshipping is something which is very new. It started because of the COVID. Facebook decided to allow people to ship products inside the United States, and instead of the only local pickup that they had before. So now you can actually list products using dropshipping to Facebook Marketplace. And when someone is buying from you, you can send it directly to them. You can get the payment from Facebook directly, or you can forward them to your external Shopify store or anything like that. And in this way, to get more traffic. For sure, the amazing part with the Facebook dropshipping is that it doesn't cost money. Like, Facebook brings you all of the traffic instead of you bringing, like you do on Shopify, and the traffic there is crazy. In my opinion, Facebook will go and improve it more and more. Now it's super new, and you can see that it's not really done until the end from Facebook, but you can get sales like almost immediately with low amount of products, which is amazing. And yeah, I am sure that Facebook will spend more time and more efforts to improve this thing. And in the near future, I guess that this will be a marketplace where everyone is buying.
Yes, so now yeah. Facebook has more than, I think, 1 billion buyers, the Facebook marketplace on all the world, so it's bigger than Amazon, actually. The problem is that not everybody can ship right now, not any country, maybe just the USA, and maybe England as well very soon. But I'm sure that next year or maybe next 2 years, everybody could ship on Facebook. So it's very good opportunity to start now, because the best money are coming from new place always. So if you can find the trend marketplace today, you can be the first that start there and know better the process. It's like people when started on eBay like 10 years ago, they made actually millions from eBay. And I think they are living free of money today. But you can do anyway good money today as well. That's all about Facebook. So maybe you can, yes, you can give us last tip for who wants to start dropshipping today or who wants to start dropshipping on eBay today or Facebook. Do you have some special tip for them?
Yeah, sure. So the first point that I like to say on every interview is focus and be consistent. So eBay dropshipping is a business as any business, and it can really be consistent. So even if you see that in the beginning it's a bit hard, just keep going and stay focused and remember why you started, and always remember that it's a business and it takes time. The second thing is really about the customer experience. Put efforts to optimize this process. Create your own pre-made replies so you can really answer your customers quickly. Even if you're in a vacation, I know a lot of people who go to vacation then come back and their store is already locked because they just forgot about it. So we have this amazing thing called your cell phone. Use this to answer your customers. Just log into your eBay account, answer everyone, and continue your day. It will not take you a lot of time, and it's really important to do that. And I think that's all. Start slowly, product by product, in the beginning to really get feeling of how it works, understand the platform, and then you can start scaling. But don't start scaling from day one too fast. Be patient and the results will come, because if you will not be patient, the results maybe will come, but then your store will be suspended because you grew too fast and you didn't know how to work with this store and with dropshipping.
Yes, it's also important to go maybe for good formation, because what I say to people, if you want to go faster, just learn from other people that already did and spend some money, go for yourself, and for sure you will be better than try and test what is going on if you can learn from other people. So it's better spend some money information as well for yourself, spend on yourself before and after you start, and for sure you can be wrong like this. So thank you, Leo, for having today here. I'm sure that Italian people that are watching us are very happy about this, that you asked a lot of their questions that they are coming from months. So thank you for your time today. And let's see us on How.ds. And thank you again.
Thanks for having me here today, Daniel. And for any question, ask below this video so me and Daniel can answer your questions. And I really enjoyed this interview, Daniel. It was super interesting, and I'm sure that it will give a lot of value to your valued audience. And thanks.
Thank you.